Good evening. Deadly storms have ripped through parts of the state. Destructive gusts obliterating homes, tearing down trees and leaving thousands in the dark. More than 200,000 lightning strikes have been recorded. And as we go to air, wild storms are again smashing the southeast. Our team of reporters is live tonight across the region, ready to bring you with up-to-date information. First to Lily Greer. Lily, what's the latest right now?
Well, right now, Josh, there is a severe thunderstorm warning in place for much of the southeast. We are in the firing line right now for hail, damaging wind and rain. And I can tell you here at Kangaroo Point, we have got a front row seat to it all. The wind has really picked up just in the last minutes. The rain is picking up as we speak, and we have seen a number of lightning strikes over the Brisbane River. Now, this system, it was frightening on the radar and it was frightening on the ground. We could see 8 different storm cells sweeping across the southeast. And what it brought was heavy rain, which caused flash flooding in low-lying areas. We saw 62 mils in under an hour at Jindalee, 60 at Pullen Vale, and lightning strikes could be seen at Raby Bay, and hail, large hail, recorded out at Zilmere, at Carindale, at Manly West. It was observed here in Brisbane too, and take a listen to this hailstorm that landed in Manly West. Right now, it looks like this system is going to pummel Brisbane again in a matter of minutes. This is our fourth consecutive day of severe thunderstorm weather, and I can tell you southeast Queenslanders are getting sick of it. We just have to get through Wednesday. There is the potential for another severe thunderstorm tomorrow, but then much better weather on Thursday. We are going to have the full weather wrap-up and rundown for you, Josh, a little later in the bulletin.
Lily, thank you. Well, this comes as southeast Queenslanders count the cost of a cyclone-like storm that swept through overnight. The supercell not only destroying homes, but deadly too, as Christmas turned to chaos.
Lighting up like a Christmas tree, an unexpected sky show. Whoa. 250,000 lightning bolts bearing down on Christmas Day. A superstorm plunging 120,000 homes and businesses across southeast Queensland into darkness.
Oh my God, power just went out.
It was like some tornado, a cyclone must have just hit this area.
At daybreak, the devastation unfathomable. Houses blown to smithereens, including Glenda Davidson's safe haven of 21 years.
It blew the glass doors out and then just took the house with it. Absolutely terrifying. It was a roar.
Parts of her roof now resting on power lines, but it's the powerless feeling she had, knowing her daughter and young grandchildren were buried in rubble, sheltering in the bathroom when bedlam hit, that's hard to shake.
They just stayed in there till it was safe to crawl out. And they just crawled out like a little tunnel underneath. I thought they were gone. It was just awful.
The destructive storm was deadly. A 59-year-old woman killed when she was struck by a falling tree.
The lightning struck and I thought, oh, hang on a minute, something wrong there.
Paramedics did everything they possibly could. There were some really challenging circumstances in that job. There was torrential rain. The storms were still going on.
70 millimetres of rain pelting down in an hour and wind gusts of 106 kilometres an hour on the Gold Coast, sending trampolines flying and causing chaos for caravans and campers.
I've never seen anything like this.
Helensvale Holiday Park turning hellish.
It's been horrendous. We are in a bit of dire straits.
With temporary homes crushed under the weight of tree trunks.
There's a lot of scared people out there going through shock. A lot of these people, like this van here, they got out just in time. Family with kids, they were very lucky to be alive.
Chris Noonan had been lying in this bed when his roof was ripped off.
Before all the bricks came down on top of me, I just got up, just in time.
Even cranes crumpled, police closing and blocking several roads with debris, trees, power lines and sheets of metal scattered everywhere.
To give you a sense of how unprecedented this storm was, they've never before seen concrete power poles taken down by a storm.
While many people are counting the cost today, others are counting their blessings. This is one example of an incredibly close call. With their cars hidden beneath branches, Daniel and Debbie spent their Boxing Day fighting the uphill battle to get to their front door.
It's like a bomb's gone off.
My clean pool that we were swimming in at 3-4 o'clock yesterday afternoon is now decimated. It's full of glass shards from the pool fencing.
While at Jeff Nielsen's place,
we eventually turned the lights on and realised that there was an entire roof on our house.
Flung from the neighbour's roof across the road as this storm shatters families in more ways than one.
To wake up and look at the extent of the damage and, you know, Christmas, it's just horrible.
Jacob Chigo, Nine News.
Let's go straight to Jacob Chico in Helens Vale. Jacob, you've been with locals there today. This is unlike anything they've seen before.
Josh, southeast Queensland is used to summer storms, but speaking to residents in the northern end of the Gold Coast, people who have called this place home for many decades, they're describing last night's monster storm as unprecedented. And it seems like this behind me that we are still seeing right around the area. There are thousands of trees still scattered across homes, businesses, cars, even the Helens Vale State School here behind me. There have already been more than 1,000 calls to the SES for help over the last 24 hours, and no doubt more calls are on the way, but we have been reassured by the state government that help is there for residents in southeast Queensland. There were concerns there were too many volunteers up in the far north, but those volunteers who were helping with the flood recovery efforts up there, they're back home and they're ready to provide a much needed helping hand for this cleanup. Josh, this one will be a big one.
Sure will be. Jacob, thank you. In more bad news for thousands of Queenslanders still without power, residents are now being told it might not be restored until Sunday. Crews and communities pulling together during a window of clear weather today to try and begin the mammoth clean-up mission.
Lending a helping hand. Neighbours pulling together has been a silver lining.
Amazing. I've been told that it's just so good they've been here and cleaned up.
The storm hit residents now facing days in the dark.
10 minutes and everybody's not got any power to charge up phones.
It's a similar situation for many. As of tonight, 120,000 homes are without power. Energex says it could take until Sunday before the lights are back on.
We're really having trouble accessing some of the network. There's a lot of people on the roads at the moment, and that's definitely hampering our efforts to try and get into some of those areas.
Every available crew is on hand. Giant gum trees are also blocking roads. They were the biggest culprits for snagging, then dragging vital power supply to the ground.
This has been a massive event, probably the single largest event we've seen on the Gold Coast in over 20 years.
For some, it's critical.
There's 10 people who require oxygen at home, so we're getting that.
As well as power cut to homes, telecom towers are down, traffic lights on the blink. Movie World, one of four theme parks to be closed due to damage. Shops suffered too. Boxing Day blockbusters and bargain sales interrupted by the outages.
We are assessing at this stage whether it meets the threshold for a disaster activation.
The Premier's office tonight saying those assessments are being delayed by more wet weather. The Queensland Reconstruction Authority expected to make a decision this week. Anna Rawlings, Nine News.
Let's cross live now to Gracie Richter in Surfers Paradise. Gracie, the wild weather closed theme parks on one of their busiest days. When will they reopen?
Josh, the cleanup is still underway at theme parks. Normally, thousands flock through the gates on Boxing Day, but for those that did turn up today, they were stopped by staff at Movie World and told to come back another day or head along to SeaWorld, which was the only theme park open for trade. Dreamworld was also unable to welcome guests due to damage from the storm, coming as a huge blow for the tourism operators during their peak season. There was no damage to rides themselves, animals and staff all unharmed, but the theme parks required a significant cleanup effort. Topgolf and Paradise Country won't reopen until later this week. And Josh, Movie World is set to reopen at 9:30 tomorrow. The same for Wet n Wild, pending further storm damage tonight. As for Dreamworld, they're yet to make a decision on when they'll reopen their gates.